Dicono gli Atlanti che la Sicilia è un'isola, e sarà vero, gli Atlanti sono libri d'onore. Si avrebbe però voglia di dubitarne quando si pensa che al concetto di isola corrisponde solitamente un grumo compatto di razze e costumi, mentre qui tutto è mischiato, cangiante, contraddittorio, come nel più composito dei continenti. Vero è che le Sicilie sono tante, non finirò di contarle. Vi è la Sicilia verde del Carrubo, quella bianca delle saline, quella gialla dello zolfo, quella bionda del miele, quella purpurea della lava. Vi è una Sicilia babba, cioè mite fino a sembrare stupida. Una Sicilia sperta, cioè furba, dedita alle più utilitarie pratiche della violenza e della frode. Vi è una Sicilia pigra, una frenetica, una che si estenua nell'angoscia della roba. Una che recita la vita come un copione di carnevale. Una, infine, che si porge da un crinale di vento in un acceso, dibagliante delirio. Gesualdo Bufalino. Ciao a tutti, I am Simona Shortino and I was born and raised here in Sicily, in the southeast corner of the island. I am a tour guide and thanks to my job, I consider myself a sort of bridge that links Sicilian beauties and culture with my guests. Today, thanks to this short video, I would like you to be a special bridge. I'd like to guide you in a very interesting page of our literature and cinema. Does the name Andrea Camilleri ring a bell? Maybe yes, or maybe you pronounce the word in a different way. Andrea Camilleri or something similar. I'm just kidding you. In any case, the right pronunciation is Andrea Camilleri, and his popular character is the Inspector Montalbano. Today, scholars talk about the Montalbano effect to describe the incredible phenomenon of film-induced tourism or sign tourism that affects the southeast of Sicily in the last 10 years. But firstly, I need to start from the author Camilleri. He was one of the most important Italian writers of contemporary literature, a pillar in today's scene. He died last year at the age of 93 and he was Sicilian. He published his first novel in 1994. The title was The Shape of the Water, La Forma dell'Acqua. This was actually just the first novel of a very lucky series of the Inspector Montalbano. Actually, Camilleri published more or less 21 books. The protagonists of his books are actually two. Firstly, of course, Salvo Montalbano, this commissario or inspector, very, very Sicilian. He is a middle-aged man, handsome, stubborn, proud, blunt and honorable, smart, and food and women lover. He is not completely a hero. He is simply a true person, one of us. On the other hand, the other protagonist is Vigata, the little Sicilian town where the episode takes place. Vigata is an old town on the coast of the Mediterranean Sea. It has a historical city center with an old cathedral, beautiful marina, and hundreds of stunning corners made of narrow streets. There you can see iron balconies with old ladies chatting behind colorful flowers. You can lose yourself in an incredible blue sea with a white beach and a yellow countryside dried under the sun with few carob trees here and there. Vigata, I think, is Camilleri masterpiece. But coming back to the story, in 1998, a TV production Palomar wanted to transform Camilleri novels into a TV series. Of course, they want to film in Sicily, but where? Firstly, they went to Port Empedocle near Agrigento. That is the Camilleri birthplace. Of course, when he created Vigata, he took his inspiration from the Port Empedocle of his childhood, that is around 1930, after the First World War. But in 70 years, the city has completely changed. Port Empedocle today is a modern town with very large asphaltic streets, buildings so many floors, so it's completely different. This is the reason why the director Alberto Sironi decided to move elsewhere to find a perfect location. And they get to Ragusa. And they get to my place, that is Ragusa's area. They arrived in Ragusa by chance and without any doubt and without any hope to find their location. But immediately they fell in love with the atmosphere of the place. It looked exactly as the Vigata that Camilleri described in his novel. The only thing is that Ragusa is quite far from the Mediterranean Sea. We are around 500 meters above the sea level. So they started to go around in the area and they found Punta Secca by the sea. And then they found Scicli, that is considered a sort of little treasure. In the stone canyons. In short, they fell in love with the whole area. So Sironi, the director again, decided to film the episodes here in an area of more than 50 kilometers, that is 31 miles. To be honest, the towns weren't ready to host either a huge TV production nor the following tourist flow. Yes, because the TV series Il Commissario Montalbano soon became popular all over the world. To give you some numbers, Camilleri books are actually translated in more than 120 languages, and the TV series is shown in 20 countries. The point is, what is so special about Montalbano? Recent surveys show that the key to its success is the location. A dream place where time stopped and fixed the beauty somewhere in the story. So now you can understand what I meant at the beginning about our strange film-inducing tourism called Effetto Montalbano. In the last 10 years, the area around Ragusa, I mean from Modica to Punta Secca by the Mediterranean Sea, saw an exponential growth of tourism, really unexpected. And that's so peculiar. Is Ragusa a perfect location for the movie? Yes, it is. But is it a touristic destination? Absolutely no. No big hotels, no highways, no touristic menus at the restaurant, no equipped beaches. Everything is very wild, natural, authentic, the real Sicily. Moreover, the frame in which all these locations are is the Baroque, the late Sicilian Baroque of Val di Noto, that today is part of UNESCO Heritage List. Talking to you, I'm craving a tour in these places. I would like to guide you here physically, but you know, at the moment it's quite impossible. I may share with you a virtual tour to show you all the churches, gardens, noble buildings, squares. But I think virtual tours are too cold and distant to feel the atmosphere of a place. So I got an idea. I'll suggest you some movies filmed here in this side of Sicily. I think cinema as literature is a good bridge again that crosses space and times to lead you in my place. So, of course, you can easily find the episodes of Inspector Montalbano online, but also Divorce Italian Style, a movie by Pietro Germi with the handsome Marcello Mastroianni as protagonist. The movie is entirely filmed in Ispica, nearby Ragusa. Then The Star Maker by Giuseppe Tornatore and Malena of the same director. They describe perfectly the contradiction of Sicily and female roles are very special. They are filmed in Sicily, but in particular the scenes of the panoramic view and the little corner of the towns are filmed here around Ragusa and Siracusa. So have fun and enjoy. I can't wait to see you here soon. Bye bye!